smell it in the grass.
Well, at least the practice fields where there is grass. This is the best time of year for sports fans. In the late August grass, it smells like football just about everywhere. Oh, oh, oh. Today's a game I've been waiting to see all year long. The South County Stallions are on the field with the Fairfax Lions. Wizards Heat here at Capital One Arena tonight. It'll be the first home game of the 2018 season for Washington. It also might be the first game in uniform for Dwight Howard. Dennis, 5-yard out route to Miles Greer. Nifty little move back inside around Joseph Blumberg, and he's on the downtown train.
The sequel begins tonight. The Caps will be on the ice against the Carolina Panthers at 7:30 p.m. at Capital One Arena. How's this for a different scenario from last year? The monkey is off their back, the pressure's off. Most of the guys that'll be in a Caps uniform tonight out at Capital One Arena have their name engraved on that cup. It's a part of them. They are a part of history.
You know, there has only been two times since 2014 that a Virginia 6A state title game has not had one of these two teams playing in it. Four state titles over that period of time, so you can say this game has been pretty important over the last decade.
That's right, Jessup. The Redskins making some moves last night. They made a trade with the Denver Broncos for a quarterback. They give up a sixth round pick. They will get a seventh rounder, as well as 31-year-old Case Keenum. Case joins a long list of Redskins. Well, in fact, the Redskins have started 10 quarterbacks in just 10 years. Check out what we've done here. We've turned L'Enfant Plaza Station into Quarterback Central Plaza. What do you think? Can you name all these guys?
Welcome to another week of the best stuff in sports.
Better believe it.
Chad, Ricardo, I can't think of anything better than high school football, especially as we get to the state championship level. A headline in the Washington Post read, "This team is so good, no one will play them."
Not the Cavs' first time at number one. In fact, they have been there four times in the last 6 years under coach Tony Bennett.
Preparations are being made in the city of Alexandria to remember a Titan. Herman Boone died last night, 48 years after leading his football team at T.C. Williams High School to a state championship. At the time, President Richard Nixon said that team saved the city of Alexandria. Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to State Championship Saturday on High Def High School. It's an all-Northern Virginia affair in 6A ball. It's also an all-Dark Side affair. Both of these two defenses call themselves the Dark Side. Coach Darrell Overton's Freedom Eagles come down from Woodbridge 14-0 and averaging 66 points per game. All right, hold on there. Stop that now. You give me just four more hours before you get all buried in the Hallmark Channel. Big story this week, Bryce Young has changed his commitment. He was headed to Southern Cal, now he's going to Dixie.
Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Joe Ball, Chad Ricardo. Welcome to InRide.com's High Def High School, brought to you by Quality Chiropractic.
Joe Ball, what is going on with your voice right now? Bro, you sound horrible.
I know, Chad. I went online and I looked up sexy voices, and I ordered this one off of an internet website.
We also saw that back in 2011 when VCU made their improbable run to the Final Four. Well, their fans are here in Columbia in droves to see the Rams take on 7'6" Taco Fall and UCF here at Colonial Life Arena tomorrow night.
Hold on, partner. Your car has never been worth more, and InRide.com is giving you a way to cash in.
That's mine, son.
And Liquid Image has led the way now for 25 years.
As we kneel down to Dexter Levi.
There are five Virginia schools in the tournament. Two of them are here, VCU and UVA. And out of all the Virginia schools, you gotta think UVA's got the most to prove. Guys, I gotta tell you, there's a lot of pressure on UVA. I didn't see one player smile yesterday in the locker room. They are somber. And counter that to the way Duke is. We were in their locker room as well yesterday. Zion Williamson, he's a celebrity. And the players are having to fight to get on the court for practice through a mob of photographers. But they're enjoying it. They're smiling. They're laughing. They're jumping on each other's backs. UVA, they may be all business, but it seems like they're feeling the pressure here.
We just want to get past it.
The 2021 4A Maryland State Champion Quince Orchard Cougars and Coach John Kelly have driven across town to pick on their little brothers, the Paint Branch Panthers.
It's a little bit of a different feel this year. How many times have we said the Capitals are the best team in the NHL at the end of the regular season, and then you say to yourself, I just don't want to get my hopes up again this year.
That's right, Jonathan, and there's more. These two schools are only a couple of miles apart. There's a big rivalry going on tonight. Last year, the Garfield Indians made a big state playoff run. The team that knocked them out of the playoffs was their opponent tonight, the Woodbridge Vikings. You got to see Woodbridge a couple of weeks ago against Forest Park. You know about DeAntoine Williams. He is big and fast at 200 pounds. But Woodbridge also has another speedster, Demetrius Quarles, number three, and they have got a strong defense, returning nine starters from that state title game a year ago.
And Coach Mickey Thompson told me his team was terrible at the beginning of the year. He told me they were terrible when they were 6-0. I asked him that at the end of this game.
Oh, I'll tell you what, that's pretty damn exciting when guys making plays like that. Bailed me out because I was feeling guilty about that being one down. But
2 years in a row, last play of the game.
Yes, so proud of those guys, man. They fight like hell.
All right, would you send your 16-year-old son halfway across the world to live with a family who doesn't speak his language in a culture he's not familiar with?
You remember that?
Yeah.
You remember how we did?
Yeah.
We did good.
Yeah.
Well, this is Ilya Besedin. He's a 16-year-old hockey player from the Ukraine.
I will tell you, good counsel's on a climb. But I'm going to disrespect good counsel a little bit again.
One more time for all of the fans at home. One more time you can add us if you win this game. You'll be busy celebrating.
I think St. John's is going to take this game. Hey, what's up, High Def High School? Today, the game of the week is out at South County, SoCo LB. This is where it all started. Friday morning lights on ABC 7, November 5th. 2015. Jordan, how old were you in 2015?
I was about 10 years old.
10 years old. Do you remember?
I remember. My brother was out there playing.
Michael Salisbury was the quarterback along with DeAndre Clayton. An unbelievable combination for Coach Brian McGackie back then.
And up here in Northern Virginia, Daryl Overton's Freedom Eagles, who are 13-0, and they are just plowing through their schedule. They are already up 14-0 in the first quarter against Western Branch. Western Branch is a newcomer to the state semifinal and final round, but they are an athletic team. They are big. Jeff Overton, the talented sophomore running back, will be leading the Eagles against that tough defense. The winner of that game will face the winner right here. Fairfax comes in 13-0. The Fairfax Lions, led by megastar Tony Rojas, are taking on last year's state semifinalist, the Madison Warhawks.
Look at where we came, all right? We are family, and we push